In this video, I will show you how to create a map between an external code system and SNOMED CT using the Automapping function. I'm going to take you through the entire process. So we will start with importing an Excel sheet, then we will do Automapping, approve the mapped terms, and generate a reference set, and eventually we will export this reference set. You can find maps in the reference set view, which is here, and this is where our map will be eventually saved as well. And there are two different kinds of maps. There's simple maps and complex maps. And let's just take a quick look at a simple map. A simple map is used for one-to-one mappings between SNOMED and alternative coding schemes. So you can map SNOMED CT to custom codes or the other way around, and also to ATC classifications. It's basically just three columns. This is a map between SNOMED CT, which is the referenced component. You can recognize it by the top level icons. And the map target is the CTV3 codes, which is here. Of course, you can maximize it as well. And you already know this user interface because it's the reference set editor. So there's a filter search here. I can type something in and it will filter my members. You can add members, you can remove members, inactivate them, display inactive members, and so on. Okay. The complex map looks pretty much the same. It just has a few extra columns, and I'll show you this one, which is SNOMED CT to ICD-10. And these, you see, this is again SNOMED CT. Oh, by the way, if you click this here, it will adjust the width of the column, so it's a little bit easier to see, or I can maximize it. So these extra columns are related to specifying the rules for the map execution. For instance, here you can also specify the level of generalization and specialization, but I don't want to go into too much detail now and save this for a later section. I just wanted to show you what a complex map looks like. Okay, let's close these and start mapping ourselves. What I want to do is I will use an existing file with local terms and create a map to SNOMED CT. And the file I have is basically just a simple Excel worksheet. So it has local codes. And here are the clinical terms. So they're just very few, just to show you. Obviously, in practice, this is a lot bigger what you would use. Let's close this. And I just saved this on my desktop. So before we can import, we have to create a project, which is in the Project Explorer's view. And a project is a top-level folder in which you can put folders and files. For instance, there's the B2I examples project, and there are different folders and then different files in each of them. And we're going to create one for us. And to do this, all you do is you go into this view and you right-click it to bring up the context menu. Then you choose New Project. And you go to General, Project, and Next. And then it asks for a project name. I will call it Mapping Example. And just hit Finish. And here it is. And now I can import my Excel file, which is very easy. You just right-click it. You go to New Reference Set Automapping File. And then all you have to do is browse for it, and it's already on my desktop, so I just open it. If it has headers, like my sheet has, you want to leave this box checked, and if you don't, then you uncheck it, and it also is set for skipping empty lines. And now I have to give my file a name, let's call it diagnosis mapping example local to SNOMED CT. Finish. Okay, and now you see it's already here and it already opened this mapping view. And let's take a closer look at this one. So this is the Automapping editor. And it's similar to the spreadsheet. So it took actually the headers here. So we have the ICD codes that I showed you on the Excel sheet. We have the clinical terms, which was my header. And then the two columns for SNOMED CT equivalence and mapping modes are empty because we haven't performed the mapping yet. If you click this, it will adjust the width of the column. Okay, to do the mapping, all you have to do is click this button and then it prompts you in this dialog box. So the column of the source value is not the ID code but the clinical terms. So I'm going to choose this, and then you can restrict it to a top level concept, and since we have all clinical findings, I will choose clinical findings, but I don't have to do this. And then all I do is hit OK, and now you see it filled up the empty columns, and you can see the mapping mode is auto, and here are our SNOMED CT equivalents, and the mapping hasn't been accepted yet, and the other ones are not so important right now. So you see one here, the impacted earwax, it couldn't find a match, so I have to do this manually. What I have to do is I just click this field, and if I click these ellipses, then the quick search will come up that you already know, and it has impacted earwax already in it, and it shows you the approximate matches, and the first one is actually the one that I want to use. So I just click it, hit return, and now it fills this in, and you can see the mapping mode is not auto but revised. You can also change the other terms as well just by simply clicking it, and then it will always give you different options, and just hit escape if you want to get out of it again. Okay, to accept them, you can either do it manually, just like this, just if you click this field, if you're just going through them one by one, or if you just glance through them and you see that it's all correct, you can also mark all of them and then right-click it, and then you have the option to approve mapping states. And now you see they're all accepted. And that is important because only the terms that you accepted will be used to generate a reference set. Okay, and now since we're finished with this, we can save it here with the save button. You see the little asterisk disappeared. We'll minimize it again. And now we can actually generate a reference set. By the way, whenever you bring up this file from now on, let me just close this to show you, it will already have the mapping saved in it and accepted, but you can of course make changes whenever you want to. Okay, now let's create a reference set, which is this icon here. So this one is for auto mapping, and then this one is for creating reference sets. I have to give my reference set a description. I'm just going to call it diagnosis mapping example. And now my map target is the ID code. The ID column is the ID code. And as the source terminology is SNOMED CT, so I don't have to make any changes. Created reference set. now my changes have been committed, and you see there was a change here as well, because this one showed up. This is the my reference set that I just created, my complex map type reference set. It will always be generating a complex map. This is required to have the additional data related to whether or not the matches are exact or inexact. So you always end up with this kind of reference set. And if I click this, you see it's again the reference set editor with the filter search, and I have my 19 matches because I approved all of them, and now of course I cannot make changes anymore because it's mapped. So that's the difference between this one. Here you can make changes. So this is the automapping editor, and this is the reference set editor. Okay, let's close this again. Okay, so the last thing we want to do is we want to export this file to our local system. This is by just going on it in the reference set view. You can also use this button, but let's try this one here. Right click it, and then there's the function export reference set. And now you can choose the file where it will be exported to. I'm going to call it diagnosis mapping example. I want to save it on my desktop. Go to save. And you also need to choose the effective time. There's a little calendar where you can pick it from. So let's just pick October 15th, which is today. Then when you go next, you have the different components that will be exported for a review. And then you go to next, and then you get a scary warning, which you can pretty much ignore because it's not going to take very long. It will actually finish in a few seconds. Okay, it's already it. And now it tells you that the selected SNOMED CT components have been successfully exported into RF2 format, and then you can follow this link. Let's just go to finish, and I'm just going to show you. It should be on my desktop now, and there it is. And if I can unzip it here, and here is your exported reference set of your local Excel sheet mapped to SNOMED CT. Okay, that's it. Thank you.